Yeah, man. Elliot Wilson contest back in LA. This is Arin Ray, man. Aaron Ray, baby. Man.
Yeah, yo.
Platinum Fire?
Yeah, man.
Dropped in March, man. For people that don't know, one of the hottest albums of the year, man. I was like, we got to do the car test, man. It already passed the car test. Cheat code alert. It passed the car test, but you got so many incredible songs, man. I want to talk about it,
appreciate
man.
That. Appreciate that.
What's that process man. Been like, man? You was behind the scenes writing joints for Chris Brown, everybody,
yeah,
and now it's your time.
It was definitely great, you know, doing all that writing, doing, you know, being able to work with the artists, being able to learn from them. You know, that was really, you know, what I took from all of that is just really learning the process.
X factor to that.
But now, being in front of, you know, the people, you know, talking more, being out, you know, it's been really cool and really different for me because, you know, I really like to be reserved, but, you know, I gotta do what I gotta
turn
do.
Turn up, man. Cincinnati to LA, man.
You already know,
day
my
in LA.
Yes, most definitely. You see.
So, did Jeep have any significance? We're gonna ride around to that record?
Nah, it's my first car, so yeah. We're gonna ride around in my first car. It's always a vibe. Yeah.
Got Young Rubicon. In there.
Yeah.
Hey,
I'm a father, man. You already know. Daddy gang.
Let's vibe out, man. Yeah. Take me to the streets of LA, man. Platinum Fire.
Platinum Fire.
Aaron Ray, baby. Car test. We back.
Let's do it.
Yeah. Enrolling, baby. Car test. Aaron Ray, baby.
Let's get it.
Cincinnati. You know you waiting in these Cali streets, man?
Yeah, man.
So what was the process like for you, like, putting this record together? Did you feel the pressure? Like, this is my moment. This is, like...
I didn't really have too much pressure because I didn't really think too many people were, like, checking, you know, for me. So it really was just, you know... Try your best, do your thing.
Yeah. Was there a certain sound you was going for, or a certain thing you thought that a unique position or something in the space that you felt like, okay, this the music out here is lacking this, and this is what I could bring to the table?
I mean, I definitely wanted to bring like more soulful music, like definitely more like more storytelling, I guess, soulful music. You know, kind of get more in depth in the lyrics than, you know, the regular "I love you, you love me" type of thing. And really just made sure I had great melody. Melody is like my biggest thing, to have something, you know, that you can just love to hear over and over and over again. So, yeah, with the melody, like...
Like, I was wondering, you have a lot of hip-hop cats in your record, too. Like, I wonder that influence. Because nowadays, there's such a blurry line of, right, what's R&B, what's hip-hop. But I feel like you merge the things very well with the guests you have on the record.
Yeah.
It don't feel like R&B, hip-hop collaborations. No. It feels
it's
like just music.
Yeah, no, yeah. And I learned from, you know, a lot of producers out here in NG, you know, being from Cincinnati and shit, you know, high-tech, you know.
Yeah.
He always made sure that shit smacks.
That knock, so, right?
Know, yeah. So, and I was always into, like, the Talibs, you know, and the Mos Defs, the Black Star, all that. So I really just, you know, had to make sure I still kept that, you know, that body.
Do you have a favorite off the album?
My favorite off the album is Scheme. I'm not trying to waste my time with the way you've been. Just go. I was found from overseas. She was supposed to be waiting on me. Tell her fine, she was with a hater. A 9 to 5, she was doing favors. Favors. I know these darlings just come and go. Go. I never thought that she was one of those. Nah, I never knew that she was one of those. Nah, I should've known that she was one of those. She wanna fuck with the drugs, with the company. And want it all, want it all, want it all for free. She want the Benz with the pain and the Tiffany's. Hit it good, it's so good every time I eat. But never once was she all for me. I need a down bitch, but that's something she can be. And that's real. He said, I saw an interview, he said, like, most of the songs are based off real experiences. Yeah.
I feel like that might be one of them.
Definitely. You know, it definitely got some truth to that story, man. It's just, you know, it's really got to do with, like, you know, that the L.A., like, me meeting this chick that I really liked or was really into. And it was really hard for me to get with her, you know what I mean? Like, to really, like, do that because I was just, you know, having fun on her. But I really tried, and then she just played. You know, it was terrible. I was like, yeah, so... That's what that song is really about.
Does she know who she is?
Nah. I hope she does. Probably not.
You know you was going to address that story? Or just kind of flowed?
I mean, I heard the beat. And, like, Nez gave me the beat from Nez and Rio. He, like, yeah. He sent me the part of the beat. And I'm just like, I have to do something. So I got something. Like, I started doing the melodies in my head. I kind of recorded on my phone. Yeah. Then I waited till I got to the studio. And I told Rob, I'm like, bro, I'm going to kill this shit. Like, I already know. And as soon as I got in there, it was real organic. Like, a lot of songs on my album, like, really organic. It happened really, like, you know, from, like, a situation. I came in and I just snapped and did it.
About you, the type of cats over the mixing board all day.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Like, shoot, the whole mixing time, you know, we was mixing the album with Cyrus and Ali. Ali did the whole thing.
Oh, Ali, bro.
Shout out to Ali. Killed it. engineers. Yeah, no, I was there every year. Engineers, man.
And you in there getting on his neck.
Yeah. I was there the whole time.
He wasn't like, young boy, it's your first joint? Man, Come on, man.
He really, you know, they were very supportive, you know, what I wanted, and, you know, what, you know, how I wanted it to sound. Because, you know, I'm very picky, and I'm like a perfectionist. So, like, it'll be some little shit they probably be like, in their head, like, man, this ain't even nothing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But I'm just so
you hear it.
You know what I mean? Like, I got to hear it a certain way. So, you know, they were patient with me, and, you know, they didn't really trip, you know. So it was really cool.
Yeah, so some of you were saying, like even some of the collaborators you haven't even fully got to kick it with, but, like, with your connections and Rod and just people hearing your music, the respect level's there, that people want to collab with you or do records with you. Like, that must make you feel good as a young artist to already have people, like, the feedback to them want to get on a record with you is like, okay, sure. And then deliver, like, good some stuff, shit. Not some BS.
Yeah, that's the main thing. It was like, man, I was so happy that they really took their time with these records, man. Like, you know, with Ty, he killed it.
Yeah, I want to get with that Ty.
Yeah, Ty and with Drum and Shoot Terrace, everybody, you know, who contributed to the album. It just, you know, they really cared, and that was what, you know, I was really.
Because you can hear it when the artist is just kind of like,
because it'll sound like something they done before.
Like, talk about the record with Ty. Like, how did that come together?
Well, Take, man, shoot, that was a stress, because it took me so long to, like, write the verse. And I had the hook forever, you know what I mean? Because I really, like, I really almost didn't finish the record, to be honest with you. Because it was like, I couldn't write it, and I don't like putting out stuff I'm not comfortable with. Like, as far as, like, a verse.
So I had to feel like you were forcing it.
I felt like I was forcing it. And Rod's like, nah, man, nah, you got to finish it. Everybody, Marissa at the label, like, nah, you got to finish it. I'm like, man, no, man. I'm like, leave me alone, bro. Like, I'm like, for real? I'm like, leave me alone. I cannot write this for shit, but... Yeah. But luckily, I got good friends who can write songs too. So I have my homie Rook Monroe, who he is really one of the only other writers on my album. He came through and helped me write that verse, my first verse on that record. So, you know, shout out to him for, you know, really coming through. Just wanna take you.
Yeah.
kind of got bored at first, like when I kept hearing it and I had no outro, so I just had to like, I had to make one. That was my shit though, man. Shout out to Ty Dolla $ign. He really like, bro, I can't even lie. Like, I don't even care if niggas be bodying my own song. I don't give a fuck. That shit be wild, bro. I really enjoy when they, you know, they do their thing, so.
Yeah, and drama came through too, man. That joint is crazy.
Nah, communication, man. Drama. Again, like, I didn't expect him to do, like, what he did. Like, he really took it to, another level. Like, I really, like, because you hear how my voice is. Like, it's all, like, sweet. Yeah. It sound like it's kind of like Michael Jackson. It's, like, Liberian Girl.
Yeah.
But he really went, like, Marvin Gaye-ish on it. Like, he really did it. Like, if I was, like, you know what I mean? Like, an MJ, he was, like, Marvin doing a record. It was cold. Like, I'm like, bro, like, hell yeah.
When life's trying to get through, it's just a matter of love. And time will be fine, don't confuse. It's just a matter of love. It's still my love. I got you better. I got you better. I got you better. I got you better. It's still my love.
Yeah, the way you come in at the end of Dron's part, it just pieces right through.
Thank
like.
You, man.
But the good thing is these records feel like they're still your records. Like,
yeah, no, like, yeah, that's what
people
I'm saying.
People can say, oh, he got murdered on this, whatever, but it's your record, bro, though. And you can tell the vibe of the record is your record. It don't feel like you're writing a record for somebody else.
Nah, yeah, and it's still your records. It's a blessing for them to be, you know, catch this vibe.
Fuck the topic, why you on? Stop that acting like you know me. Talking about my old friends like we home. I get it how I live and they don't know me. Talking about some old shit like you know me. Like you know me. Nigga, you don't know me. Talking about my old bitch like you know me. You don't know me. Nigga, we ain't homies. No, no. What's up with these clown ass niggas? Got your bag, so you tryna come around ass nigga. Tryna show me that you damn ass nigga. On the thing now, my 10 toes to the ground, my nigga. You watch too much TMZ. You Google my net worth. You heard some shit from a chick I smashed. You believe her. You mad cause you play the background like reverb. You front row hate, wearing YG t-shirt. Don't do me like that. You don't know me like that. I got on, I did my shit, I don't owe you like that. Ayy, put 400 on the map. Ayy, you ain't got nothing to do with that. Ayy, this ain't no rap, I made up this shit facts. Ayy, ayy, I'm for sure pop, I'm for sure pop. They wanna be my friends now, that's how you know I'm pop. I'm for sure pop, I'm for sure pop. I got white friends.
need a better to run your mouth. Oh, honey. You don't know what you're talking about. What's your motivation? You say you know me, but got no relation. Your Instagram got you feeling famous. Could give a damn about your confirmation.
Don't be acting like you knew me before, man. I was trying to get in the studio with y'all, man. I was trying to write. They wouldn't let me in. It's all good, though. It's fine. We good. We here now.
Speaking of love and respect, I know you got, actually, you sampled him, a legend, Busta Rhymes on the album.
Yeah, man.
And that's a crazy story. Like, you actually met him when you was a kid?
When I was young as hell, yeah. My mom liked to go to concerts. She always took me to concerts with her. So, you know, she took me to Busta Rhymes down in Cincinnati one time.
Wow, in Cincinnati.
Yeah, Cincinnati, yeah, you know. And she took me out there. We was, you know, I think, I don't know how old. She said I was like three. I was super young, but I seen the pictures. I remember the pictures. But I was just out there, you know, and, you know, after the show, you know how they hang around, like, the hotel or wherever they was. We kind of just bumped into them low-key. And Bus was just like, I like to perform, so I was always, like, dancing, moonwalking, doing all the extras, trying to get attention,
kid.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And, you know, he sees me dancing, he's like, oh, who is this kid? Yo, man, like, this dog, he's going to be a star. That's what my mom told me, like, he's going to be a star, da-da-da-da. So it's just a blessing for him to be able to, like, clear and... clear the sample and just be able to have his voice on my record. And it's like, what, man? I can say I really got Bus on a record. Sir, yeah. Sir, again. Body. Sir. Call the body. And then Lord Quest with his fucking beat. God damn.
Gotta have the right team, right?
Yeah, man. Got to.
Left to say to you, you act like I ain't paying my dues. I'm picking up the pace. It's all about the chase. You could try to fake the moves, but that'd be a way to lose. Just another phase. There's someone for your place. Yeah,
nigga, all I hear is rah, 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 rah. Can't reply, way too high for all that.
Yeah, da, da, da.
Yeah, I know niggas used to be
gang, 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 gang.
But in life, there are things that we just can't maintain.
Gangland is the mainframe.
Heartbeat of the city is where we were born. I didn't know shit about shit back when you put me on. You told me what was legit and what was ludicrous. Never let the home girl know I was new to this.
Yeah. One of the joints, also a joint that wasn't going to be on the album because I was being lazy.
But, oh, for real?
Yeah, man. But it was just because I just could not finish it. But again, man, these artists be inspiring me. Sir came in, heard the shit, and was really only helping me low-key write it. But then didn't even do that. He wrote his own verse and inspired me to, like, finish my melody and finish writing mine. So it was just like, man, again.
True,
like,
collaboration.
Just real, you know, that was like a real collab. So it was really cool, man. Really dope experience.
Yeah.
Platinum 5,
man.
Title track.
Title track in stores, in streaming, in everything.
My dog. Man.
Finger snaps, man. Finger snaps.
Those are real snaps, man.
Definitely passed the car test.
Thank you, man. Always appreciate that.
And Ray, baby, car test title. Yeah.
Let's get it.